This month, like many of you, the city will be celebrating the nation's birthday with fireworks. The City of Salem invites you to celebrate this year's 4th of July at Salem's Riverfront Park. The park will be open all day, and by mid-afternoon, food vendors will be set up in the park. Fireworks will begin around 10:15. This City of Salem sponsored event is free. Arrive early to grab a good seat, and for more information about the event, contact the city's Park and Rec Division. If you choose to celebrate at home, here are a few important tips for staying safe this 4th of July from Salem Fire Department's Deputy Fire Marshal Laird Case.
We have 27 locations within the city that sell fireworks. About half of those are what we call outside sales or tents or stands. The other one will be in stores. Those fireworks are all what we call Oregon legal. It was our recommendation that you always buy from Oregon legal. They'll have a license. They'll actually have a permit posted from the state of Oregon that says they're legal to sign, to sell. I mean, we've got a little thing we post on our website, and it says, we call it the four B's: be prepared, be responsible, be safe, and be aware. And each of those have things that you need to do. Make sure that you keep them away from children. All year we promote keep matches and lighters away from children, and then come the 4th of July, we hand them a device that's sparking and say, oh, that's okay. So it sends a kind of a mixed message to our children, but as long as it's done safely and properly supervised, there shouldn't be any children out doing fireworks by themselves. You have to be at least 16 years of age to purchase them. Be prepared. You keep the pets inside. It's one of those things you got to prepare, because they could run off, get hurt, or run in front of a car. Another thing is always have water. One of the best things to put out these type of things is water. Everybody goes, well, I have a fire extinguisher. Well, fire extinguishers is a dry chemical, and it doesn't penetrate this as well. The basic thing I talk about is when you dispose of them. People think they're out, but basically these devices are got a very small amount of pyrotechnics in them, but the rest is cardboard and paper, and so it smolders. It's no different than if you took ashes out of your fireplace. You think they're cool, and you put them in a container that's not good, a box or something like that, and then leave them, and then the wind picks up, and then at night we have a fire. And so water is your best thing. I always tell people, once you're done, soak them, fill them full of water, put them in a wheelbarrow, put them in a bucket, move them away from your house. If you have what we call a dud, one that didn't work, they're out there. Don't try to relight it. Let it set for a while, then put it in water and let it soak. You don't think you'd have to say this, but these fireworks are used outside, not inside structures. Be aware of your surroundings. So it's going to be extremely dry, so it's not going to take much of these to get a good grass fire going. Fireworks are not legal in the parks or on school properties and stuff like that. So that's another thing we got to emphasize this. We also have a flyer on our website, which is what's legal and what's not legal, because there's questions. If you have any questions or concerns about any safety around the 4th of July, you can contact the Salem Fire Department's Fire Prevention Division.
For more safety tips or reminders, emergency information, community alerts, or just to keep track of what's going on, check out our webpage and Facebook site. While on Facebook, check out the Salem Police.